The Minute 19 pulse flow experiment in the lower Colorado River Delta allowed scientists to have an interesting opportunity to study many different aspects of a flood, from the water quality to recharge rates and volumes to the actual flood itself. And Jeff Cordova and I were able to install CSA, or continuous slope area sensors, in a reach just downstream of the dam that was opened up where the flood was released. These sensors allow us to estimate what the discharge is, and normally we put these gauges, or these continuous slope area sensors, in areas that are impacted by wildfire or are just hard for our technicians to reach, so it's hard to actually get to a spot and measure. And a difficult thing to estimate when we do this kind of method is the roughness that the vegetation actually pushes against the water during the flow event. And you have to estimate this while you're in the field, and this goes into the Manning's equation so we can estimate discharge. In this unique event in the pulse flow in the Colorado River, we're able to put these sensors in, and we knew when the flood was coming and how big it was going to be, so we could prepare before the flood and get and collect as much data as possible during the event. We also had the ability for our scientists in the Yuma field office to make high quality and very highly accurate discharge measurements using ADCPs, or acoustic Doppler current profilers. And they did this at multiple times during the event, which allowed us to have very accurate discharge measurements, where we could compare this with the CSA, or the continuous slope area sensors, that we had deployed in the reach. This gives us the opportunity to actually back calculate the roughness value at the times that our technicians in Yuma measured discharge. During the installation of the CSA sensors, all the sensors in the reach were programmed to collect stage, or the depth of water, every 5 minutes throughout the duration of the flood event. Once the sensors were properly programmed to collect data at the correct intervals, the sensors were anchored in the channel to prevent them from moving during the flood event. Once the CSAs are fully installed, we mark each cross-section associated with each sensor in the CSA reach so that a survey can be conducted to record both the shape of the channel and the height of the sensor at each cross-section. Here we are surveying the channel geometry at each cross-section using a total station. This is an accurate tool used to measure the height of each sensor as well as the shape of the channel at each cross-section in the CSA reach. The prism at the top of the survey rod is used as a target for the total station. When using this equipment, there needs to be line of sight between the total station and the prism. This is not always possible given the winding nature of rivers and the vegetation you can see here. In such cases, a reference mark is used. Here it is a stake hammered into the riverbed and is used as the reference mark. The mark can be seen from multiple cross sections where the total station is moved. This ensures that the survey between the two points where the total station has been set up remains on the same plane.
Yeah, this is going to be CSG X4. The pin will be 4. Yeah, I'll do the top of the T-post and then I'll try to get the sensor level. Ready? This is Brandon Forbes, April 25th. But I'm going up to our uppermost sensor in the slope area reach. The water's about 6 feet deep here. Channel changed quite a bit, but it's way deeper than it was when we first installed the sensors. Yes, and there she blows. Looks good. Stable. It's in this clay layer here. Very, very nice.
Now that the flood is over and the dam is now shut off, we have conducted 3 surveys of the channel bottom and the heights of the 4 sensors that we deployed in the reach. And we've also measured the water with ADCPs multiple times during the event. Now we're looking at all the data and we're going to compare the two and see what we get. It's very important to survey after the flood because a lot of times the channel can change. And what we're seeing already is that the channel is filled with fine sediment that was carried from the dam and down into the reach where we measured. And this can affect the cross-sectional area of our estimates. So it's very important to capture this now, right after the event occurred, so we can have the closest estimate of what the channel looked like while the event was happening. this is an efficient tool to measure the channel profile and the channel characteristics that we use in a lot of streams in Arizona. It's called an RTK GPS, and this is a highly accurate survey grade GPS unit that we can take out into the field and measure the channel properties without line of sight. Traditional survey equipment like the total station, you need line of sight, and it's far more difficult to get through the canopy and through vegetation that we have on the banks of the streams. The RTK GPS allows us to go to any point where we can get a GPS signal and that we want to know the exact X, Y, and Z coordinates of that point. In Arizona, it's very difficult to get to a flood while it's occurring because floods happen so fast. And in this unique opportunity, we knew the flood was going to happen, which gave us an incredible heads up on what we could collect during the event and then now process after the event has occurred to try to learn as much as we can from the post-flow event. Now we're compiling, collecting, and analyzing all the data that we collected during the flood event, and we hope to have interesting results we can share in the very near future.